audio and visual. So why it is known as media? Because media has different dimensions. Medium is a connectivity tool between the thing known and the person who is an aspirant of knowledge. And what is that multiplicity or polydimensionalism or pluralism in between these people? It is visual presentation, categorical presentation, allegorical presentation, depictive presentation, narration, dialectical presentation in the form of audio, visual, cacophonical, catastrophic, various other dimensions of constructive and destructive mechanisms are there. This type of multiplicity, multidimensionalism and polydimensionalism has given the plural name known as media. So media is the connectivity tool or the rajju or sutra between the prameya and pramata. The person who is knowing and the thing that is known is connected by various tools such as sound effect, visual effects, boosting, mounting, pictorial depiction, graphics, processing, color therapy, aroma therapy, expression therapy, various other methodologies are there catering to the need of exploiting or exploring or experimenting the sensational, temptational and allegorical inner hidden views and feelings of all of the people by which they are well nurtured, mastered and commercialized by media, which is known as media because of its multiplicity. It has various types of sounds, it has various types of forms, it has various concepts, it has various dimensions, it has various methodologies. Even if you take a subject of entertainment, there is a horrible entertainment, there is a comedy entertainment, there is a fiction entertainment, there is a religious fiction entertainment, mytho-fiction entertainment, science fiction entertainment, sports entertainment is there, pure religious ritualistic entertainment is there, suspense thriller is there, shock thriller is there, detective thriller is there, innumerable divisions are there. So this multiplicity of inputs given in various forms on various levels to various people depending upon their invariably variable taste, that is known as media. That is the definition of media where we are going to start with now. So we are in drishya and shravya, the thing that is audible and the thing that is visible, which are connected with pixels and voxels in modern scientific terminology. Pixels in phonoforms and photoforms, they have been given norms as pixels and voxels. Pixel is the photo basic tool or the basic dust that is known as pixel, you know, pixel cameras. Likewise, voxel is for sound. This is the modern technology and terminology for all of these things. It has started with which is the embryonic primeval element for all of these various emancipations or expressions or expansions. That is from Nataka. Everything has started from Nataka, the external drama. Where this external drama has started from your internal dramatic activities. So the drama started first from us, then it was first staged inside our inner mind, then it is staged inside an auditorium, then it was staged in the streets and other places, then those things have been captivated in the form of a silver screen, small screen and stage screen and various other industries that are now flourishing and about to flourish. So it has started from the mind. Mind has three basic instincts. One is vibhava, second is vibhaga, third thing is prabhava. What is vibhaga? We are having a drama. For example, if you are going to school, then you are acting only the role of a student, not son, daughter, civilian or something else. In the society you are a civilian. In the professional environment, you are a professional. In the family, you are the component of the family. So domestic, social, academic, professional, neighborhood, spiritual. So we are having innumerable divisions. So we act. That is the first drama. But that is a genuine and realistic drama that is known as vibhaga. Second thing is vibhava. We are having some money, but yet we say that we don't have in order to safeguard money or in order to prevent that money going to somebody. So we are just awakened and yet we are saying that we are sleeping or asking somebody to say that we are sleeping, or even at times foolishly we say that we are sleeping to people. So this is known as vibhava, in which we hide our own feelings and we express something different. That is vibhava. Third thing is prabhava, not for any cheating purpose but for representation and demonstration purpose. Somebody, they assume a divine disguise, which is known as transfiguration. Icha sharira grahana. Transfiguration is a bhava by which a person takes a different form. What is rupa vibhava or rupa prabhava? If a person is young, he can take the disguise of an old man, a crippled man, a handicapped man, a clumsy man. These things are rupa. He is acting as an engineer, doctor and other things. So everything is different. His age, his modulation of his voice, his patratva, that is characteristic determination, everything that differs. That is known as transfiguration, that he does with vesha, bhusha, bhasha, rasa, bhava and avarna. That is cinema. What is vesha? That is in disguise. What is bhusha? That is in special tunings. What is bhasha? In modulation and delivery. And what is rasa? The concept or theme that he has taken. Bhava is the expression concurrently and coherently is delivering as per the theme. If the theme is petas and he is laughing unconnectively, that won't be nice. So expression is something connective. Avarna is the background. So these six things are the basic assembly of the Nataka industry. There are three rupas. One is Bimba Rupa, Bhava Rupa and Swarupa. If there is a spectator of a drama, if somebody is crying there, and if that crying person is there in the Bimba Rupa, just as a shadow, immediately that person will not cry at all. He will not respond at all. But if the same Bimba Rupa of the actor reflects on the Bhava Rupa of the person, immediately the person cries, because that intertwines with the person's bhava, the naturality or inherence, and makes the person to feel what the person feels. So if it is in the peripheral coverage, it is unreflected. If it is in the middle coverage, it is reflected. If it mixes with the Swarupa, he becomes the same thing. He gets into characteristic identity. There are a lot of killers, psychic killers, who have been very decently or indecently transformed into psychic killers after seeing movies or getting into entertainment contacts. So whenever the Bimbarupa is unaffected by the same Bimbarupa at the peripheral, it does not make any difference. If it gets into the Bhava, the person gets an ephemeral or transient type of feeling. If it gets into the Swarupa, the person is affected with the characteristic presentation which deeply penetrates inside the mind of the person. He becomes the character at all, whether it is salubrious or pernicious to him or the society is different. So it gets inside. This is a rule. So more than the other tools of experience, number one, our own experience. Number two, narration or depiction which we have from people. Third thing, observation of other people. All of these things are very limited. How can we observe a lot of things? How can we experience a lot of things? How we can get things through imagination? How far we can derive from the narration of others? So cinema or nataka or media is the fifth tool, which is known as pradarshana or effective demonstration, in which all the other gaps and defects of the other tools of imagination, observation, narration or depiction and experience can be totally settled and reconciliated, by which a perfect consummate structure of a complete and holistic experience can be brought out. That is the greatness of this media industry. Psychologically, we must understand psychology, commercial psychology and social psychology, without which nobody can start a channel. Even if they start a channel, they cannot run a channel without understanding the trend of the society and the mindset of the society. There are innumerable things we used to call in the Shastras as various divisions or angas. For example, there is Keli, Neeti, Natya, Nataka, Kala, Vidya, Adhyatma, Prachara, Vichara, Krishi, Prakriti, innumerable things are there.